Well, I thought I'd illustrate what needs to happen in a Westfalia for the alternator light to work correctly. We have the fuse panel disconnected. It'll be similar in the 86 and up, but this is an 85, so it's got the old style fuse panel. Basically, you need to find the, if you look under the rear seat, I don't have it open, but there's a relay there, and the blue alternator white wire goes to that. And what you need to do is find the cable jacket, which happens to be this one right here. See the black cable jacket, and it's got a large red, which is constant battery on. Then it has the blue alternator wire, and that triggers the relay over underneath the driver's seat. And then there's this red and black, and I'm not quite sure what that is. I just haven't really spent any time tracing it out. But what you need to do is snip this blue wire that goes to the underseat relay. And obviously I just have jumpers here just to kind of show you the layout. And I'll post a link to a wiring diagram in the description, and that'll help. But what you're doing is you're basically splicing in, so the red connection here and the black connection, follow these with me. You're basically splicing these, my wire just came off, but you're splicing these onto a relay, a 5-pin relay. Now, this red connection that I was showing earlier, that actually connects to the alternator wire, so the one that feeds the, or from the alternator, and it also feeds the light on the dash. And then this guy right here, this black one that fell off, this one will produce a signal that goes to the underseat relay, and that goes on this middle pin here of the relay, the new relay. And so it's hard to do with one hand, but that goes right there. Okay, and then pin 30 and the right pin here, looks like it's pin 85, I believe. I don't know, I'll have to look at it. I think it's 85. Yeah. Those go to an ignition on source. So the black is just jumpering to this red here. It's just jumping to here. There you go. Just jumping to there. And then the red is actually going up here to a fused source. Now, since this is temporary, I'm just kind of showing you kind of the layout. It might be easier just looking at a wiring diagram, but this, you know, this is just for those visual types that need an idea of how to get this working. So now when the belt slips off, or if it breaks or something, your alternator light will work. And the alternator light will also not be blaring at you, you know, because if you don't do this fix, then it's always going to be on, and you have no idea whether or not it's actually failed, or if, you know, it's just giving you a false signal. So anyway, I hope that helps. I'm gonna get it wired up here permanently, and I'm gonna mount the relay right here in with all the other relays, and we'll be all good. Alright, so the relay is installed. It's sitting up here. You can kind of see the red zip tie holding it in. So we'll start the engine and you'll take a look at the alternator light. See, so the alternator light fix works well. If you unplug the cables, it won't work at the alternator, but if the belt is not connected, that's when it'll actually show that, it'll indicate that it's not charging. So it's a good indication for when the belt is either too loose or falls off. So the computer is now secure, and I've used this bolt right here on the Westie cabinet to secure the OBD2 port. And I also had this piece of aluminum shielding laying around, so I just screwed it up into the bottom of the cabinet just to lessen the chance of anything happening to the computer. So you can just take your OBD2 Elm reader and pop it in. And now you have wireless gauges, which is pretty awesome. And they work great. And I'll show you a preview of that here coming up. Hey guys, I wanted to do a quick video showing how to use the OBD Fusion app. Makes gauges really nice. There's multiple gauge displays. I mean, it's totally customizable, which I really like. So I'm not in a Subaru Vanagon conversion or a bus, but I am in our 2008 Forester. So let's take a look, and I'll show you how I use this tool. So right away you can see it's very handy for basic gauges. We've got temperature, RPM, and voltage. That's super nice, just, you know, having a big display, and when you turn it, it's really nice too because it takes the whole screen, which is kind of cool. And this is on a standard iPad 2, but it also works on the iPhone, which is handy. I don't really use this gauge setup, it's kind of default, but I do use this one, which is super nice. It gives you tachometer here, timing advance, intake pressure, fuel trim, intake temperature, engine temperature, mass airflow, and throttle position. I haven't used this gauge on this car yet, so some of this stuff might be kind of funny, kind of odd, but I'm going to just press on the throttle just to touch and see if anything changes with TPS. And it looks like it does a little bit. This is not a mechanical throttle. This is a solenoid-operated throttle drive-by-wire. So it's actually a little different than any. I haven't done a Vanagon conversion or VW conversion with drive-by-wire yet. So it might behave a little differently. But anyway, it's just a quick little video showing kind of some of the basics. The device that the iPad is connected to goes into the OBD2 port. If I can get a light down there, you can kind of see it right there. And it's wireless, so it uses WiFi. Don't get the Bluetooth ones. Apparently they don't work well. So go with WiFi. And it's super helpful. I like this equally, if not more, than a scan gauge, just because it has so much functionality. If you look on the left here, you can see so many different things. I mean, you could even run maps if you wanted, which is pretty wild to me. I wouldn't want to be looking at gauges than maps, but you know, it's just got a bunch of built-in functionality. Logs, diagnostics is super helpful. It'll pull up any of the diagnostics for your vehicle. We don't have any on our Forester right now. But it's super helpful when you're looking at a VW swap, because you'll find a bunch of odd engine codes that don't really pertain or hurt the performance of the engine, but it'll drop a code for you here. So it's just good to keep an eye on those in a VW swap. So super handy tool. Hope somebody can benefit from this.